Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Allahumma salli wa ansur alaina min qada'i rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Rabbi
Amin.
syrahli sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli.
Amin.
Rabbana atina fid dunya hasanah wa fil akhirati hasanah wa qina adzabannar. Sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad
Amin. Okay. Ramai yang tolong aminkan dekat belakang. Okay. Alright, so hari ini kita nak discuss quizzes. Okay, so quizzes tu banyaklah yang kita belum discuss. That's why saya fikir-fikir I need to discuss all, bukan all lah, selected question today. So that hari Isnin nanti kita tak panjang sangat. Okay, sebab hari ni kita baru habis 7.1 lah. Kalau kamu dah tengok all the videos, kita baru habis sampai buffer. So kita ada 7.2 and 7.3 that we need to finish before kita exam lah. Okay, alright. Okay, so nanti 7.1, lepas tu saya akan proceed to 7.3 dulu and then baru 7.2. Okay, so kamu jangan pelik lah. Okay, next week. Alright, kejap. Okay, and then regarding exam, saya rasa kamu semua dah tahu kan exam yang siapa yang di rumah exam bulan 1 nanti, siapa yang di KML akan exam yang akan datang yang terdekat ni lah. Okay, so semua dah tahu kan that one?
Tahu, Miss.
Tahu, Miss.
Tahu, Miss.
Okay, so hopefully walaupun yang exam jauh tu bolehlah prepare awal kan, okay. Tapi sengsara jugalah, orang lain dah merdeka, kamu baru nak exam. Tapi ada pro and con lah, okay. Alright, so let us start. Kita start dengan mana? Share screen. Okay, so kita start dengan quizzes, starting from the first quizzes yang chapter 7, definition of acid and base. Okay, so semua saya tengok banyak yang dah jawab lah, okay, quizzes ni, tapi ada beberapa orang yang belum jawab. So saya tak pasti apa masalah, sama ada line ke ataupun apa. Okay, so kalau ada pun masalah tak boleh buka ke apa ke, then please inform me lah. Okay, so sebab saya buat this question, saya fikir oh nak bagi student faham the basic so that dia boleh faham benda yang lain. Okay, and other than that kan exam kita objektif, so please take quizzes ni seriously lah. Okay, sebab dia soalan objektif. Okay, so let us start with the first question yang saya tengok yang saya perlu discuss. Okay, quizzes definition acid and base dulu. Okay, so dekat sini soalan tanya, if a solution is basic, which ion will be more? Okay, so ion mana yang banyak kalau solution tu base? Okay, so saya terkejutlah juga to see 16 participant answer H+. Okay, so H+ adalah for acid kan?
Yeah, miss.
Miss.
Okay. Yeah. Alright, so this is very basic one. So please bear in mind that kalau base, that mean dalam solution kamu tu banyak OH minus lah. Okay, banyak OH minus ion. Okay, so H plus ni adalah untuk acid. Kalau solution tu acid, that mean banyaklah H plus dalam solution kamu tu. Okay, and then for K plus and H minus, this is not related at all. Okay, so I don't know why some of you answer that. Okay, so tak apa. And then next one, which of the following correctly identify acid-base pair? So that's mean dia tanya yang mana satu acid, mana satu base dalam satu pasangan ni lah. Okay, so yang the first one, HH4 plus dengan OH minus. Okay, OH minus can be considered as base lah. But for H4 plus ini pelik. Okay, so mungkin tak pastilah wujud ke tidak. So mungkin tak wujud pun. So bukan. And then H2O dengan OH minus, okay, kita hold kejap. CaCO3, CaCl2 ini bukan. Okay. And then HNO3, H2SO4 ini adalah dua-dua asid. Okay. So salah lah. Okay, and then the only option left adalah B. Tapi saya tahu mungkin ramai yang fikir, oh, water. Okay, water dia boleh jadi acid, dia boleh jadi base, depend pada keadaan dia sebenarnya. Okay, so kalau kamu tengok nanti ada keadaan di mana acid, water tu jadi acid, kadang-kadang water jadi base. Okay, so this one can be accepted lah as the answer. Okay, so that one. And then next one is this question here. Okay, ini very simple tapi ini penting sebab later on kamu kena betul-betul faham the definition of Bronsted-Lowry model ni to be able to write dissociation equation of acid and base correctly. Okay, kamu kena boleh tulis equation tu betul. Kalau equation kamu, dissociation tu kamu tak dapat tulis ataupun kamu tak tahu macam mana kita nak tahu apa produk dia. So actually it depend on the definition of Bronsted-Lowry ni lah. Okay, so kita boleh tengok sini, kita ada NH3. NH3 is ammonia. Ammonia acid ke base?
Yes.
Okay, so ammonia is a base. So that's mean in this case, H2O will become acid lah. Okay, and then you have to find dia punya pasangan dia, pasangan dia NH3, dia punya pasangan dia adalah NH4 plus lah. Okay, dari mana saya tahu? From ni lah, lebih kurang kan dia punya formula dia. Okay, and then next one adalah H2O, dia punya pasangan dia adalah OH minus. Okay, so if NH3 is a base, that means dia punya pasangan dia over here adalah conjugate
acid.
Acid.
Yes, okay, so this is conjugate acid. Okay, and kalau ini acid, that mean this OH minus adalah conjugate base. Okay, so you have to remember they always opposite. Macam tu lah, kalau base, pasangan dia acid, conjugate acid. That mean dia dah behave sebagai acid lah. Okay, and then kita dah tahu dah benda ni. Okay, so lepas tu soalan tanya, what is the conjugate acid according to Bronsted-Lowry model? Okay, so yang mana conjugate acid, kita dah pilih dah tadilah. So the answer is NH4+. Okay, so ramai boleh jawab this question tapi saya nak tunjuk juga sebab saya nak tekankan kepada cara menulis equation yang betul. Okay, so kalau ikut definition of Bronsted-Lowry, ingat tak apa yang dia cakap? Okay. Alright, so Bronsted-Lowry dia cakap inilah. Okay. So mana-mana acid ni. Acid is a substance that can donate a proton. Okay. A proton here mean H+ lah. Dia akan donate H+ to another substance. That is acid. Acid donate. Okay, cara nak ingat dia ACID ni. D ni maksudnya donate. Okay. Alright, so kalau base pula dia accept H+ tu. Okay, so that is base. Okay, so kita dah tahu dah itu. Lepas tu barulah kita pergi balik kalau equation ni. Kalau NH3. Okay, so NH3 dia adalah base. Kita dah tahu. So base maksudnya dia akan accept H+. Okay, so bila dia accept H+, that's why NH3 become NH4+. Okay. So hopefully kamu boleh nampak lah dekat situ kenapa dia ada extra one hydrogen. Okay, and then for H2O, since they behave as acid, acid tadi kita kata D tu donate kan, so they donate H+. So when H2O donate H+, that means H2O is left with OH minus only lah. Okay, so ini cara dia tulis equation dia. Okay, so later on nak tulis equation, always fikir acid donate, base accept H+. Right, so any question on that one?
So far tiada, Miss.
Tiada, Miss.
Okay, thank you. Alright, so next kita pergi pada quizzes calculation. Strong acid, strong base. Okay, so for this calculation, I can see that yang jawab. Kalau ikut dalam saya punya report ni, participant paling sikit lah jawab ni. Mungkin sebab involve calculation kah? So mungkin kamu rasa macam malas sikit nak buat. Tapi tak boleh lah, kena buat lah. Okay. So, what is the concentration of KOH when pH is 11.89? Okay. First thing adalah calculation, kita ada dua jenis. Okay, we have two different type of calculation. Kalau strong acid, strong base punya calculation dengan weak acid, weak base punya calculation, walaupun dua-dua nak cari pH, cara calculation dia lain. Okay. So, saya start dengan strong acid, strong base sebab strong acid, strong base is very easy. So, bila dia senang, kita start dululah. Okay, and kenapa dia senang? Sebab kalau kamu perasan macam dekat sini, saya nak cari concentration of KOH. Okay, so nak cari concentration of KOH, saya pun tulislah equation dissociation of KOH ni. Okay, this KOH is a base lah. Okay, so bila dia dissociate, dia akan jadi K plus dengan OH minus ion. Okay, and as you can see, my arrow here adalah arrow yang single je, single headed je, bukan yang reversible. Kenapa arrow macam ni? Kenapa bukan reversible arrow?
100% dissociate.
Yes, thank you, Brian. Okay, so itu betul. Okay, itu jawapan yang tepat lah. Okay, you should remember ini antara benda penting about strong acid and strong base lah. Okay. Strong acid and strong base, dia punya specialnya adalah when you place it in water, okay, dia akan dissociate 100%. That means semua base tu akan bertukar jadi K plus dan OH minus lah in this case. Okay, takkan ada dah KOH tu dekat hujung, nanti dah tak ada dah KOH. Okay, dia dah jadi dalam bentuk ion. Okay, so itu strong acid, strong base lah. So that's why kamu kena take note kalau dalam chapter 7, arrow untuk strong acid, strong base, dia mesti satu arrow. Okay, to show that they 100% dissociated. Okay, and then daripada situ, pengiraan kita akan jadi lebih senang lah. Okay, so kita kenapa senang? Sebab kita tengok dulu apa kat sini. Dia kata concentration. Okay, so nak cari concentration KOH over here. Actually, this concentration KOH is the same as concentration OH minus lah. Okay, so kenapa the same? Sebab dekat sini kamu boleh tengok concentration initial untuk ini, let's say lah this value here. Okay, so initially K plus dengan OH minus ni zero, tapi habis je reaction tu, kita tahu KOH 100% dissociated. That means finally dah tak ada dah KOH. Yang tinggal adalah K plus dengan OH minus. So concentration dia sama sahaja. Okay, as long as dia punya stoichiometry dia samalah. Okay, tapi saya tak cakap lagi macam mana boleh dapat this value kan daripada pH. Okay, so soalan bagi pH. Okay, so nak cari pH, kita kena cari daripada pH, kita cari dulu concentration H plus lah. Okay, so macam mana saya kira, okay, 11.89 is the pH, so negative log concentration H plus. Okay, dekat sini ramai yang stuck, saya tengok. Ramai yang stuck sebab dia fikir dia mungkin tak tahu nak solve log tu. Okay, so ada cara nak solve log tu sebenarnya, tapi kalau saya tekan calculator je, shift log, saya tekan shift dekat calculator tu, press shift and then press log, lepas tu kurungan negative. And then press any value yang dekat sini lah, macam in this case 11.89 tutup kurungan, and then you should get this answer here. Okay, so siapa yang tak pandai nak cari this concentration H plus, please take note on this one. Ambil calculator kamu, cuba tekan tengok dapat tak. Okay, so ini penting lah. Kamu tak perlulah nak buat jalan kira yang panjang-panjang sebab objektif je. Okay, kalau subjektif sekalipun chemistry dia tak nak tengok pun kamu punya matematik tu. Dia just nak tengok ada formula, ada ni, ada jawapan. Okay. Alright, so this is the concentration H plus, tapi as you can see KOH is a base. Okay, so this concentration H plus dia tak membawa apa-apa maksud lagi lah. So we have to find the concentration of OH minus sebab kita tahu concentration of OH minus is the same as the concentration of KOH in this case. Okay, so nak cari dia, you have another relationship that you should remember. Concentration H plus time with concentration OH minus equal to 1 exponent negative 14. Okay, so substitute je lah this value here. Okay, and then OH minus is the one that we want to find, and then you should get concentration OH minus equal to this value. Okay, which is the answer untuk ni adalah yang C ni lah. Okay, tapi saya tahu ramai tak guna this cara, ramai yang guna cara ni pun boleh, tak ada masalah. Dua-dua betul. Okay, so mungkin some of you kata, oh ini base, tapi dia bagi pH. That's mean nak cari concentration OH minus, I have to try to find POH first. Okay, so how to find POH, you have to use this relationship here. pH plus POH equal to 14, and then tolak lah, dapatlah POH 2.11. Okay, so dah dapat POH, guna pula formula ni, negative log concentration OH minus 2.11, tekan calculator macam tadi, shift log negative 2.11, then you should get concentration OH minus adalah ini. Okay, so kita tahu concentration OH minus sama macam concentration KOH. Sebab dia 100% dissociated. Okay, so that's why the answer adalah ini. Okay, so kalau ramai yang jawab ni, ada 21 orang ni, 21 participant yang answer B as the answer, sebab saya rasa dia tengok concentration H plus, dia terus ingat concentration, memanglah 100% dissociated, tapi itu H plus. Ini KOH, KOH is a base. Okay, so dia bukan acid. So kamu tertipu sikit lah dekat sini. Yang jawab ini saya pun tak tahu kenapa ni. Okay, 128 molar, wow. Okay, besarnya nilai tu. So, take note on that one. Susah ke yang ni?
Tidak, miss. Tapi boleh, saya tertipu.
Tertipu, wah. Itu biasalah. Soalan objektif memang macam tu. Sebab masa saya buat soalan, saya dah fikir, saya buat soalan jawapan yang betul dulu. And then saya fikir, what if student just stop dekat sini? What if student terbalik yang ni? So, saya akan fikir all that kind of thing masa saya nak buat soalan objektif tu. So jawapan-jawapan ni might be some of them adalah yang saya dah fikir dah, kalau student jawab ini maksudnya dia fikir macam ni. Tapi ada kadang-kadang saya dah tak ada idea dah, saya letak je lah any number yang saya rasa saya nak letak. Okay, so that itu tricky about objective lah. Okay, alright, and then next one kita tengok this question. Dia kata an aqueous solution ada 4 gram of NaOH in 250 ml water, calculate the pH of the solution. Okay. Alright, so this one again, the question asking for pH but this is base. Okay, so maksudnya before you dapat pH, you have to find POH dululah. Okay, so kita cari dulu find POH first. So how to find POH, that's mean kita dah tahulah POH, the formula is negative log concentration OH minus. So nak dapat POH, we need to have concentration OH minus dulu. Okay, so concentration OH minus kita belum ada. Concentration NaOH ni sendiri pun belum ada. Okay, so macam biasalah ini gabung balik dengan chapter 1. Okay, so number of mole equal to mass over dengan molar mass. So from here you will get the number of mole for NaOH. Lepas tu dia dah bagi volume. Okay, so this is volume of water. Tapi macam kita bancuh air Milo lah, kita ambil 4 gram Milo campur dengan 250 ml water. So kita akan dapat berapa ml air Milo? So kita akan dapat berapa ml Milo? Yes, 250 jugalah kan. Okay, so the same situation here. Okay, so that's mean NaOH solution that you will get here adalah 250 ml volume dia lah. Okay, so that's why number of mole divide with 0.25 liter. Don't forget, okay, kalau molarity you have to tukar dia kepada liter, then kamu dapat 0.4 mole per liter. That is molarity of NaOH. Okay, and kita dah tahu dah, this is strong base. Okay, kena ingatlah NaOH adalah strong base. So, sama juga macam tadi, case dia, dia 100% dissociated. Okay, so bila dia 100% dissociated, that's mean kalau initially concentration of NaOH is 0.4, that's mean concentration of Na plus dengan OH minus ni pun akan jadi 0.4 juga nanti after dia dah dissociate sebab dia punya stoichiometry dia 1, 1, 1. Okay, so dari situ kita dah boleh dapat concentration OH minus. Okay, so dah dapat concentration OH minus, so POH equal to negative log 0.4, then POH kamu equal to 0.4. Lepas tu nak cari pH, soalan minta pH kan, so nak cari pH kamu kena guna ni lah, ni relationship yang kita selalu guna, pH plus POH equal to 14. So 14 minus 0.4, so equal to 13.6. So your answer should be B. Okay, ha, tapi kalau ada yang letak D ni maksudnya dia dah tertipu lah. Okay, 0.4 ni bukan pH tapi ini adalah POH. Okay. Alright, so settle yang ni. Next kita tengok ini pula. Okay, ini ada trick dia sikit soalan ni. Dia suruh cari pH juga tapi kali ni trick dia lain sikit lah. Okay, and first thing, this is something yang kamu maybe jarang jumpa lah, BaOH2. Okay, tapi as you can see, dia ada OH, that's mean dia adalah base. So, dia strong acid, dia strong acid ke? Weak base ke strong base? BaOH2 is a?
Strong.
Yes, strong base. Okay, so ini kamu kena tahulah. Okay, kenapa, macam mana nak tahu? Sebab saya ada juga bagi example dalam ni. Okay, so in the notes, okay, you can find dekat bahagian strong base here. Saya ada tulis example of strong base. Okay, example dia adalah yang ada OH tu usually. Okay, di mana dia maybe group 1 ataupun group 2 metal lah. Okay, so kiranya metal yang group 1, group 2 combine dengan OH, dia akan jadi strong base. Okay, so macam ni BaOH2. Okay, so itu example kena ingat lah. So bila dia strong base, that's mean 100% dissociated. Nak cari pH, that's mean kita kena cari concentration OH, concentration H plus dululah. Tapi masalahnya ini base. So kita hanya akan dapat concentration OH minus. Okay, so daripada situ kena cari POH dulu. Dapat POH baru boleh cari pH. Terbalik dah pula. Okay. Alright, so ini equation dissociation ya. Okay, as you can see every time saya nak jawab soalan yang strong acid, strong base. Walaupun I stable tidak diperlukan sebab dia adalah strong acid, strong base, dia 100% dissociated. Tapi saya akan cuba buat dia punya dissociation equation lah. Sebab apa saya buat dissociation equation? Sebab saya nak check keadaan yang macam ni lah. Okay. For example, this one BaOH2, bila kita dissociate, dia jadi Ba2 plus dengan OH minus. Tapi this OH minus, kita nak kena balancekan dia lah. So we have to letak 2 dekat sini. So the stoichiometric coefficient dia ada 2. So in this case, initial concentration of BaOH2 is 0.05 molar. Okay, tapi bila dia dissociate, that's mean no more BaOH2 in the solution. We are left with Ba2 plus and OH minus only. Tapi concentration Ba2 plus adalah 0.05, the same as BaOH2 sebab dia punya stoichiometry 1:1. Okay, tapi for OH minus, dia punya concentration, dia punya stoichiometric coefficient is 1:2. That's mean the concentration of OH minus ion is 2 times 0.05 molar, which is equal to 0.1 molar. Okay, so ramai yang mungkin salah dekat sini lah. Dia anggap sini pun concentration OH minus ni pun sama macam concentration BaOH2. 0.05 salah lah. Okay. So dia maksudnya ada keadaan di mana concentration OH minus is not the same as dia punya strong base, dia punya concentration. Okay. So, dekat sini, kita dah dapat dah sini masukkan dalam equation dapat POH. From POH, use this relationship again to find pH. So, dapatlah pH equal to 13. Oh, maaf. Okay. So, ada anjing berkejaran di belakang. Okay, so pH equal to 13. pH equal to 1 ni ada seorang tertipu. Okay, so that is POH. Tapi kenapa ramai ni ya? 12.7. Oh, adakah dia guna nilai ni? 0.05. Maybe lah. Okay, so take note on this one. Soalan suka juga ni. Tanya benda macam ni. Okay, ada apa-apa soalan about calculation strong acid, strong base?
Masih okay, miss.
Tidak, miss.
Tidak, miss.
Okay. Alright, thank you. Okay, so kiranya kita boleh conclude lah. Okay, kalau calculation strong acid, strong base, what you need to do adalah kamu buatlah, tulislah equation tu ringkas-ringkas untuk check dia punya concentration OH- ni ada stoichiometric coefficient ke tak depan tu. Okay, and dia punya concentration selalu sama sahajalah kalau tak ada stoichiometric coefficient 2 macam tu. Okay, tak perlu I-stable yang bombastic tu, tak perlu I-stable. Okay, sebab dia 100% dissociated lah. Ini tak adalah I-stable, ini if-stable. Okay, initial final. Okay, so settle. Next, kita nak pergi kepada strong weak, strong acid, strong base, weak acid, weak base. Okay, so kita tengok satu-satu. Starting with this one. Which of the following is the correct balance equation showing the dissociation of sulfuric acid into ions? Okay, so ini sangat penting. Okay, kamu kena boleh tulis equation dissociation dengan betul. Okay, first thing nak tulis equation dissociation, you have to think ini acid ke base. So this is sulfuric acid, clearly this is acid lah. Okay, strong acid or strong acid or weak acid?
Sulfuric acid. Acid.
Yes, okay, so sulfuric acid is a strong acid. So kalau strong acid, that means our arrow should be like this. Okay. So if you see any equation yang dissociation of strong acid ataupun strong base yang guna this arrow, that's mean dah automatically salah. So dekat sini option B ni dah salah sebab dia dah pakai arrow reversible. Okay, so siapa yang 10 orang yang jawab ni, so please take note that kalau dia strong acid, strong base, arrow mesti satu arrow. Okay, kalau dua arrow tu dah confirm salah. Okay, and then next one, kita ada tiga pilihan jawapan lagi. Okay, so kita tengoklah H2SO4 consists of H plus dengan SO4 to minus ion lah. Okay, so macam mana kita tahu SO4 to minus ion ni? Kalau ada yang tak tahu, ini kita kena hafal lah. Macam Cl, ion dia Cl minus. Okay, sulfate SO4 to minus. Okay, so ini betul dah dissociation dia. Tapi yang salah adalah dia tak balancekan this equation. Okay, clearly over here ada dua H. That means ini kena balance dua lah. So that's why the first answer is wrong. And then the second one. Okay, sulfuric acid. Kalau kamu tengok soalan ni sengaja dia tak tulis formula of sulfuric acid. Sebab dia expect kamu tahu. Sulfuric acid, the formula is H2SO4. Sebab H plus when combined with SO4 to minus 2 ni akan turun ke depan lah. So H2SO4. So ini, this is not sulfuric acid. Okay, so salah. Okay, and the last pilihan yang ada, H2SO4 dissociate to form H plus aqueous SO4 to minus aqueous and dia letak dua depan. So ini, okay, jawapan yang betul. Okay, so okay lah. 75% tapi quite low lah percentage yang boleh determine ni. Okay, so itu sahaja untuk equation dissociation of strong acid. So next kita tengok, dia kata which of the following is the correct definition for strong acid? Okay, partially dissociate. Nah, saya baca perkataan ni pun saya dah reject dah. Okay, strong acid, strong base, partially dissociate kah?
Completely.
Yeah,
fully dissociate. Yes. Completely dissociate. Partially dissociate means kalau ada 100% mungkin 2% ke 5%, 10% je yang dissociate. Okay. So the rest tak dissociate. Okay. So dissociate ni maksudnya dia tak tercerai lah. Okay. Dia tak jadi ion tu. So salah. Oh, tapi okay lah. Seorang je yang tersesat. Okay. Yang lain tu berada di jalan yang benar lah. Okay. So fully dissociate into ion. Okay. When dissolved in water and the change is not reversible. Okay. Ini penting. Okay. Fully dissociate betul. Bila kita letak dalam air dan dia punya change tu tak reversible. Sebab tadi kan saya keep on cakap kalau strong acid punya strong base dissociation equation, you must use this arrow. This arrow maksudnya dia satu jalan je. Tak ada jalan patah balik, tak boleh lah. Okay, once, let's say lah macam KOH, once dissociate to K plus dengan OH minus, this K plus and OH minus cannot return to form KOH balik, tak boleh. Dia tak boleh form dah. Okay. So that's why ini betul lah. Okay, and yang ini salah sebab walaupun dia kata fully dissociate into ion semua, betul, tapi dia cakap dia punya reaction tu reversible. No, this is not reversible. Okay, strong acid, strong base, not reversible lah. Partially dissociate, ini salah dah. Tak payah baca panjang lah. Okay, so itu walaupun banyak je yang boleh jawab, tapi saya nak tekankan sebab saya nak make sure kamu punya konsep on strong acid, strong base, weak acid, weak base tu kuat before kita masuk this calculation here. Okay, so as you can see, soalan objektif tapi banyaknya pengiraan. So inilah kemungkinan soalan-soalan yang akan keluar. Kita pun tak tahu. Okay, so that's why saya pun carilah juga soalan. Saya tak adalah bagi banyak pun. Saya bagi 5 soalan je quizzes on this calculation sebab saya tahu perlu banyak calculation. Kalau saya bagi 10 soalan, penatlah juga nak mengira. Okay, so kita tengok dekat sini, dia bagi concentration of acetic acid, this formula CH3COH, pKa 4.75 in vinegar is about 1 molar. Okay, so concentration dia 1 molar. So what is the pH of the vinegar? Okay, so in this case, kamu kena identify this is strong acid ke weak acid. So ini adalah acetic acid is weak. Yes, thank you, Kathleen. Okay, so this is weak acid. Okay. So kalau tak tahu macam mana nak identify weak acid ke strong acid ke, ada idea?
Ada KN tu.
Yes, thank you. Okay, so you have to look at, kadang-kadang soalan bagi value KA dekat soalan tu, dia bagi value KB, it shows that itu adalah weak lah, tak kisahlah weak acid ke weak base, depend lah. Kalau dia bagi KA, that's mean weak acid. If the question give you KB, that's mean that is weak base. Okay, tapi example such as acetic acid ni ataupun ethanoic acid ni very popular one, so please take note lah this is weak acid. Okay, so dia bagi weak acid, dia nak pH. So kita tak boleh lah buat style macam soalan strong acid tu. Strong acid kita senang je. Kalau dia, kita dah ada concentration ni, so concentration ni sama macam concentration H+. Lepas tu kita pun masuklah pH equal to negative log concentration H+. So kita nak masuk pH equal to negative log 1. So siapa yang buat macam ni salah. Okay, sebab ini adalah weak acid. Dia partially dissociate. That's mean concentration of acetic acid yang asal tu tak sama dengan concentration H+ yang dissociated. Okay. So in this case you have to use I-stable. Okay, so nanti kamu soalan objektif, tak payahlah kamu buat table properly ni. Kamu just tulis equation, tulis je tepi ni sikit. Lepas tu inilah, tak payahlah buat garisan tu sebab nak jimat masa kan. Okay, so pH of vinegar. So nak cari pH, okay kita kena fikir satu-satu dulu. Nak cari pH, that's mean kita perlukan concentration H+. Okay, so our aim now, we want to find concentration H plus dalam CH3COH ni yang dissociated. Okay, so H plus dengan H2O plus benda yang sama lah. Okay, we can say dia sama lah. Cuma H2O plus ni bila dia tambah water. Okay, so nak buat ni kena, boleh tulis this equation dulu. Dissociation of weak acid in this case. So that's why saya awal-awal tadi saya dah tekankan. Okay, acid dia punya function dia adalah donate H+. So kita kena tambah dengan water sebab usually acid and base, they, it will show dia punya karakteristik bila dia kena water.
Okay, so H plus dia donate, that's mean we are left with CH3COO minus. H plus tadi pergi mana? Okay, so kalau ini H2O adalah base, so dia akan accept H plus. So H2O accept H plus become H3O plus. Okay, so dah ada equation, barulah kita plug in the value. Okay, so the concentration initial of ethanoic acid atau acetic acid is 1 molar. H2O kamu dash je sebab dia adalah liquid. Kita hanya deal dengan aqueous dia je lah in this case. So initially concentration of CH3CO minus and H2O plus ni 0. And then ini unstable, dia ada change. Okay, change depend on the stoichiometry. So semua satu-satu je. So that's why semua X sahaja. Cuma beza dia, this is minus X because ini adalah reactant. So this is the same concept as chapter 6 lah. Okay, sebab the reactant decreases over time while for the product dia plus sebab product increases over time. Okay, meningkat. So, kita dapatlah in terms of X, dia punya concentration at equilibrium. Okay, lagipun arrow dia reversible. That's mean in this weak acid, acid weak ni boleh dissociate jadi ion. And this ion can combine back to form this acid. Okay, so dia boleh pergi balik kiri kanan reaction dia. Okay, so that is what we call reversible equation lah. Okay, lepas tu apa kita nak cari tadi? Okay, kita nak cari pH, kita nak cari concentration H3O plus ni. Tapi kita dapat in terms of X. Okay, so maksudnya kita kena guna anything yang dia bagi dekat soalan untuk cari concentration H3O plus iaitu X ni. Okay, so saya akan guna pKa yang dia bagilah. Okay, so you should know pKa formula dia lebih kurang macam pH tu. So pKa equal to negative log Ka. So substitute the pKa and then Ka macam biasa tekan shift log negative 4.75, then you should get this value of Ka. Okay, so Ka ni berguna bila? Okay, Ka ni sebab kita tahu this is the formula of Ka. Macam mana kita tahu? Kita ambil product power stoichiometry over with reactant power stoichiometry. Okay, so kita pun substitute lah in terms of X dulu. So Ka tadi kita dah ada, so you can substitute, so dapat this value. And saya ada cakap kalau nilai Ka and Kb kamu 1 exponent negative 5, negative 6, negative 7 and below. Okay, that's mean we can assume that the value of X is very small. Okay, so that's mean 1 minus X equal to 1 lah. Sebab kamu assume kamu minus 1 minus 0.00003 katakan. So bila dia banyak 0 tu, dia punya answer ni akan very close to 1 jugalah. So kita assume 1 minus X equal to 1. So bila equal to 1, so ini actually over 1 darab. Lepas tu mathematically senang lah untuk kita solve. We don't have to solve quadratic lah in this case sebab kita assume X is very small due to dia punya exponent kat sini. Okay, so value of X saya dah dapat dekat sini. So this value of X sebenarnya adalah concentration of H3O plus. Okay, nah, so kita dah settle dah. Kita dah berjaya dapat concentration H3O plus. So just substitute into this formula then you should get the pH. Okay, so the pH should be 2.38 in this case. So ada juga yang jawab ni 4.22 exponent negative 3. Ini baru nilai X eh. Okay, 10 orang ni, 10 participant tu, this is value of X. Okay, not pH. Okay, so ini salah lah. Kosong. Kenapa kosong eh? Saya pun pelik. Ke yang ini dia substitute terus. Negative log 1. Ah, betul lah. Yang kosong ni dia terus substitute ni. pH equal to negative log concentration H plus. Lepas tu dia terus substitute pH equal to negative log 1. Okay, log 1 is 0 kan? So dia dapat pH 0. No. Okay, tak boleh buat macam tu. Okay, sebab this is weak acid. Okay, any question on any part?
Tidak, miss.
Tak ada. Okay, alright. Mana? Kawan kamu Muhammad Syahir Elmi ada tak?
Ya, miss.
Syahir Elmi dia pergi mana? Dia dekat KML ke dekat rumah? Dekat KML kan?
Ya, ya dia dekat KML. Dia balik sudah.
Ah, okay. Sebab kerja, sebab dia tak masuk pun dalam Google Meet ni dua kali dah ni. Okay. So, tolonglah menasihati. Tolonglah nasihatkan dia. Okay. Alright. Okay, settle that one. Next, kita pergi kepada this question. Okay, so kalau kamu tengok soalan ni dia putar-putar je. Tadi dia bagi PKA, dia minta PH. So this time the question give you PH, concentration, dia minta KA. So itulah contoh soalan yang boleh keluar lah. Okay, so kita nak cari KA. KA formula dia ini. Okay, berdasarkan equation ni lah. Okay, lepas tu kita tak ada pun data ni. Kita ada in terms of X sahaja. Okay, so maksudnya kita kena carilah nilai X tu daripada data yang dibagi iaitu pH. Okay, so pH equal to negative log H plus. So concentration H plus adalah this value here. Okay, so concentration H plus ni sama concentration H2O plus. So sama dengan nilai X dia. Okay, so ini dah dapat dah nilai X semua. Soalan minta KA, substitute lah. Then you should get this value 1.01 exponent negative 5. Okay. Tak adalah susah sangat kan soalan ni. Okay, and then next one, this question here. Okay, kita dah masuk percentage of dissociation. Okay, so soalan dia ada calculation weak acid, weak base. Lepas tu dia masuk percentage of dissociation. That's mean we want to count berapa persen weak acid tu ataupun weak base tu yang dissociate. Okay, so bila kamu kira nanti kamu akan tengok lah very little yang dissociate. That's why nama dia adalah weak acid ataupun weak base. Okay, so in this question dia kata what is the percentage of dissociation of 0.1 molar solution of trimethylamine. Okay, so kalau siapa yang dah pernah belajar organic chemistry dia tahulah trimethylamine ni macam mana formula, tapi yang tak pernah belajar mungkin dia struggle sikit, tapi tak apa. Trimethylamine is CH3, 3NH. Okay, so this is amine derivative, ammonia derivative lah. Okay, so ini formula dia. Okay, and then this is a base lah. Amine semua adalah base. Okay, so bila dia base, okay, so maksudnya dia akan accept H+. So that's why dia punya product dia adalah CH3, 3NH+. Okay, so dia ada plus tu. And then dia accept H plus dari mana? Dari H2O lah. In this case H2O jadi acid. So this H2O will donate H plus. Okay, so donate H plus. So dia jadi OH minus. So kita dah dapat this equation. Okay, so soalan minta percentage of dissociation. Kenapa perlu I-stable? Sebab dekat sini formula dia kamu boleh tengok alpha equal to concentration change. C ni adalah change over with concentration initial. Okay, so concentration initial tak ada masalah, kita memang dah ada. Okay, tapi concentration change that mean berapa berapa yang bertukar tu, itu kita belum ada nilai X ni. Okay, so itu yang kita kena cari, and that's why kita perlukan this I stable here. Okay, so that mean now we need to try to get the value of X. So kita pun gunalah data yang dia bagi. Apa yang dia bagi? Dia bagi PKB. Okay, so kita cari KB. Okay, dapat KB, masukkan dalam formula KB and then carilah this value of X. And again, this value of KB exponent negative 5 consider as very small. So 0.1 minus X, X tu pun kita consider as small juga, then kita tak perlu solve quadratic lah. 0.1 minus X equal to 0.1. So ini darab, then square root je. So you should get this value. So ini adalah nilai X. Okay. So nilai X kita nak cari sebab kita nak cari change dia. Okay. So kita dah ada dah change. Just that you don't have to take negatif ni, tak perlu. Sebab kita letak negatif ni, kita nak show dia berkurang. Okay. Dalam percentage of dissociation, tak perlulah ambil negatif tu. Okay. So ambil je concentration tadi, bahagi dengan initial. Then you should get 2.72 ataupun dekat sini 2.73 lah. Okay, so 70% dapat jawab yang betul. Empat orang terambil negatif sekali. Lepas tu yang ini 8.61% ni macam mana boleh dapat eh? Hmm. Tak tahulah macam mana. Saya tak ingat dah masa saya set jawapan tu. Okay. So hopefully boleh kira. Jangan tak kira main tekan je. Tak boleh lah. Okay. Next one. Ini soalan dia manipulate lagi. Dia bagi dah percentage of dissociation. Dia minta cari KA pula. Okay, so kita pun tengoklah daripada formula percentage of dissociation. Dia bagi this value alpha. Initial kita dah tahu. Times with 100%. That's mean from this equation, kita boleh dapat value of X. Okay, so lepas tu kita pun buatlah I stable. Okay, so ini weak acid. So acid macam biasa dia donate H+. Okay, walaupun HZ kita tak tahu what is HZ. So donate je lah. So jadi Z minus. H3O plus over here. Okay, and then kita minus semua. So X kita dah tahu dah nilai dekat sini. Kita nak cari KA. KA formula dia product over reactant. Power stoichiometry. So kita dah ada nilai X. Kita substitute je lah. Okay, so dapatlah nilai KA dia. Ada yang dapat 6.0. Ada yang dapat 3.6. 6.0 ni, ni lah kot. Dia ingat ni. Okay. So, itu je. Okay, so what do you think about calculation weak acid weak base? Susah? Pening?
Pandai terbengong, miss.
It takes time jugalah nak. Nak macam fikir, oh ni apa dia minta, apa dia bagi kan. So, tapi pusing-pusing-pusing, lebih kurang je lah. Okay, belum masuk buffer lagi ni. Buffer lagi pening. Okay, so kita settle yang tu. Next, sebelum saya terlupa, saya dah bagi soalan dekat kamu juga dalam ni kan. Yang try this one, try this two ni. Okay, so yang ini ada ada juga yang PM saya tanya macam mana buat ni dari satu. Tak ada masalah. Okay, kalau kamu rasa kamu nak tanya terus, tanya je. Okay, tak perlu nak tunggu discussion kita pun boleh. Okay, so kita tengok try this one over here. The question ask you to calculate the pH and degree of dissociation of this CH3NH2. Okay, ini adalah methylamine. Kalau tadi trimethylamine, 3-methyl. Ini 1-methyl je. So, methylamine. So, methylamine since dia bagi KB. Okay, KB maksudnya base lah. Tapi kita tahulah amine, family dia semua adalah base. So, dia bagi value KB over here. Okay, so minta cari pH. Okay, so kita fikir satu-satu. Nak cari pH, I will need the concentration of H+. Okay, usually lah. Tapi ini base. Okay, so maybe kita akan dapat concentration OH minus dululah. Okay, baru kita boleh tukar pergi ke H plus. Okay, tak apa. So, kita pun solve je dulu. Okay, kita buat dia punya equation untuk I stable. Okay, so equation and then masukkan dia punya initial concentration is 0.5. Ini 0.0. So, minus X sebab semua ni 1.1.1.1 je. Okay, so dah dapat dah. Concentration of ini semua at equilibrium in terms of X, then by using the value of KB given, we can find the value of X lah. Okay, so kita pun dapat lah. Tapi ini susah sikit. You have to solve quadratic lah sebab as you can see the value of KB given is exponent negative 4. Negative 4 kita tak boleh assume 0.5 minus X equal to 0.5. Tak boleh. Okay, you cannot do that here. Okay, kalau kamu buat itu dekat sini, konsep dia kena salah lah. Okay, so tak boleh. So maksudnya kena solve quadratic. Okay, ramai yang struggling juga quadratic ni. Tapi don't worry, just make sure kamu boleh tekan calculator yang cari nilai quadratic, nilai X tu terus tu. Okay, tak perlu nak buat B squared minus 4AC tu, tak perlu. Okay, so dapat two values of X. As usual, we have to choose which one yang kita accepted. Okay, so as you can see over here, the concentration of CH3 and H3 plus is equal to X. Okay, so if you choose X kamu nilai negative, that's mean your concentration of ini dan concentration OH minus kamu negative. So boleh diterima kah concentration negative?
Tidak.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so you cannot choose concentration negative lah. So that's why over here this value X yang negative saya reject. So this value yang saya accept. Okay, so bila saya accept this value, saya punya aim adalah nak cari apa tu tadi, pH. So saya dah dapat dah concentration OH minus lah. Okay, so dah dapat concentration OH minus, I need to find pOH first by using this equation. Then from pOH baru saya boleh dapat pH. Okay, so itu satu cara lah. Ataupun kalau dekat sini mungkin ada yang tak pakai cara ni, dia pakai cara lain pun boleh. Ada satu cara lagi iaitu we can use relationship yang mana? Okay, so you can also use this relationship here. Okay, so since you already have the concentration of OH minus, just substitute here. Then you should get the concentration of H plus. After that, you can use pH equal to negative log times with concentration H plus. Then substitute lah the value of H plus tu, you should get the pH. Okay, so ada dua cara lah. Tapi saya rasa cara ni lagi senang lah kalau saya punya start. Okay, so any question on try this one? Oh, tapi belum habis lagi. Okay, so tak apa lepas itu. And then degree of dissociation pun kena. Since dia cakap degree of dissociation, that's mean you don't have to times 100 lah. Okay, kalau dia cakap percent of dissociation, then only you have to times 100. Okay, so ini concentration change over initial. So the change is equal to X. Okay, so X kita adalah this value. So substitute and initial kita adalah 0.5. So equal to 2.92. Okay, so boleh dapatkan jawapan ni?
Boleh, Miss.
Boleh, Miss.
Okay, so boleh tak apalah. Alright, thank you. Okay, next kita tengok try this two. Try this two, dia bagi pH. Given pH. So this is the pH. This is the concentration of ini benzylamine. Okay, so determine the ionization constant and percent dissociation. Okay, percentage dissociation ni mungkin ramai tahulah that is alpha. Tapi ionization constant ni mungkin kamu pelik. Apa benda ionization constant? Okay, ionization constant ni actually Ka, Kb tu lah. Since this is base, okay, amine punya family adalah base. So the question asking for Kb lah sebenarnya. Okay, lagipun pH dia kamu boleh tengok lah. pH dia above 7, so that's mean this is base lah. Okay, so kita kena cari Kb dulu, baru cari alpha. Okay, so nak cari Kb, formula dia kita tahulah ini, tapi kita perlukan this concentration at equilibrium. Okay, so that's why we need to create this I stable over here. Okay, sebab nak dapatkan concentration at equilibrium. Okay, so ini base macam biasa, accept H plus, so jadi NH3 plus belakang. Okay, H2O jadi acid, so donate, so jadi OH minus. Okay, and then initial concentration masukkan, ni tak ada masalah, table saya rasa sebab chapter 6 kamu pun okay je. So sekarang kita nak cari Kb, kita nak cari concentration ni, kita tak nak in terms of X, tak nak sebab kita nak value kan. So kita kena cari this value of X by using information given. Okay, information yang dia bagi yang kita boleh guna adalah pH. So this pH, saya tukar dulu jadi pOH. Sebab daripada pOH, saya boleh direct dapatkan concentration OH minus. Sebab concentration OH minus tu equal to value of X. Seperti yang dalam table ni. Okay. So that's why saya cari OH minus punya concentration. Okay. So dah dapat dah nilai X. Then saya boleh kira lah satu-satu berapa concentration at equilibrium untuk setiap satu ni. Lepas tu baru saya substitute. Then saya dapat Kb. Okay, so that is the ionization constant. And then dekat sini saya letak juga alternative way to find concentration OH minus. Ini tengoklah kalau macam kita dah ada concentration H3O plus dekat atas ni. Dari mana saya dapat concentration H3O plus ni? Oh, dari pH. Dia boleh carilah kamu daripada pH ni VH equals to negative log concentration H plus. So when you substitute VH equal to 10.5, then you should be able to find the concentration of H plus lah. Okay, so from here, this concentration H plus, you can substitute into this equation. Then you will get concentration of OH minus. Okay, so another way lah untuk cari concentration OH minus. Lepas tu macam biasa lah boleh dapat KB. Okay, pasal soalan juga minta percentage of dissociation. So for percentage of dissociation, kita prefer kepada reactant sahaja. Okay, sebab kita nak tahu berapa banyak base ni yang dissociated. Okay, so this value of X, kadang-kadang dia 2X, depend pada stoichiometry lah. So in this case, dia X saja, so ambil X. Kalau dia 2X, later on ambil 2X. Okay, so this value of X substitute. Okay, so substitute nilai X ni, and then over with initial, dapat 3.16%. That's mean, dalam 100% base kamu tu, yang dissociate, yang bertukar jadi ion OH minus dan ion ini hanyalah 3.16%. Very little one. So sesuai lah dengan definition weak acid weak base partially dissociated. Okay, so sikit dia yang dissociate. Okay, ada apa-apa soalan about try this two?
Miss, for try this one itu degree of dissociation is 0.0292 or 2.92.
Okay, kejap. Kita double check balik lah ya. Concentration dekat mana kamu yang lain? Jason, kamu ada buat pengiraan dekat mana?
Degree of dissociation.
Yes. Tapi I think, oh saya salah tekan calculator kah? Kejap. Ah. 0.01461 divide 0.5.
Miss.
Oh yeah, betul.
Yang juga. Itu kan? Yang itu bukan percentage kah, Miss?
Betul. Saya salah tekan kah? Saya. Okay, so sini this one kejap should be 0.02922. Banyak sangat. Okay, dekat tu. Okay, thank you. Okay, so betul lah. Saya cakap
okay, tak payah
dah 100, tapi saya dah 100. Okay, thank you juga. Alright, so try this one, try this two, settle. Oh, almost 1 hour dah. Okay, kalau tak ada apa-apa soalan, next saya nak pergi salt hydrolysis sekejap. Okay, so sikit je lagi. Salt hydrolysis ni antara yang famous lah yang suka naik. Tapi dulu soalan dia suka naik, dia suruh kamu explain. Kenapa ini basic salt, kenapa acidic salt, neutral salt and so on. Okay, so nak explain, you should be able to write the equation. Okay, so and this is another equation yang kamu kena take note. Okay, kalau kamu perasan, dissociation of salt, okay, all equation saya, semua arrow yang, satu arrow yang bukan reversible. Okay, so kiranya you can add to your notes. Before this, kita tahu strong acid, strong base, satu arrow tu je, single arrow tu kan. Tapi sekarang tambah lagi. Salt dissociation. Okay, so salt dissociation pun arrow dia yang satu arrow juga. So itu take note. Okay, and tadi kita dah tahu weak acid, weak base, arrow reversible. But now, as you can see, arrow hydrolysis salt equation arrow dia adalah reversible. Okay, so weak acid, weak base dengan hydrolysis of salt. Hydrolysis of salt, dia punya arrow mesti reversible. Okay. So walaupun ini soalan objektif, manalah tahu kan soalan objektif tu bagi equation as pilihan answer. So you have to choose equation yang ada arrow yang betul lah. Okay, so dissociation of salt ni hopefully semua boleh tulis. Okay, simple je. Dia macam salt usually made up of acid dengan base punya combination. Okay, so dia ada ion positif, dia ada ion negatif. So NaCl, kalau kita break dia, dia jadi Na plus dengan Cl minus. Ini ion memang kita hafal lah. Okay. Kalau macam CH3COONa ni pun sama juga. Although kamu mungkin tak biasa dengan CH3COO ni, ion dia apa. Tapi you should know Na plus, Na punya ion iaitu Na plus. So kalaulah Na ni Na plus, that's mean logically CH3COO ni adalah minus lah. Okay, so that when they combine, barulah jadi this formula. Okay, so the same goes for ini. Okay, dia akan break dekat sini. Cl kita tahu the ion Cl minus. Okay, ni minus ke atas. Okay, and then NH4 dia plus lah. Okay, NH4 plus. Okay, ini ammonium ion. Alright, so kita dah settle the ion tu. Okay, and then untuk determine salt tu acid ke basic ke neutral ke, depend kepada apa jenis acid and base yang combine. Okay, for example, if strong, strong, that means strong acid, strong base yang combine, dia punya salt adalah neutral. Okay, and the pH of neutral salt is pH 7. Kalau a combination of strong base and weak acid, okay, kamu ingat yang strong tu yang dominate, that means dia punya product dia tu akan jadi base, basic salt. Okay, and the same for acidic salt lah, that means yang dominate tu adalah strong acid tu yang dominate. Okay, so itu cara saya ingat lah. So since acidic salt, that means the pH will be less than 7, ini more than 7. Okay, so kita tengok soalan quizzes yang ada 3-4 soalan. Okay, so which type of acid and base that compose the following salt? Okay, so dia bagi this salt. Okay, so macam biasa saya cakap, pecahkan this salt dulu. So NH4, the ion is NH4 plus. Cn, the ion is Cn minus. Okay. So dia suruh determine type of acid and base yang combine untuk produce this salt. So kamu kena pandai guess lah. Okay. So NH4 plus, kamu rasa ini datang daripada mana ni? This NH4 plus come from?
Ammonia.
Yes, ammonia, which is NH3 lah. Okay. Sebab apa datang daripada ammonia? Sebab kamu kena fikirlah, ammonia is a base. Base pula dia accept H plus. Okay, so bila dia accept H plus, NH3 jadilah NH4 plus. Okay, so lagipun dia punya formula lebih kurang. So itu cara kita identify lah. So base is a strong base or weak base? And base is strong base pula. Ammonia is a weak base ke strong base?
Weak base.
Yes. Okay, weak, so please base. Remember, ammonia is a weak base. Okay, so kita dah dapat satu answer lah. Okay, so yang mana strong base ni salah. So ini salah. And ini salah juga. Okay, so kita ada dua possibility dekat sini. Okay, so yang mana antara dua tu. So next we have to identify Cn minus actually come from HCN. Okay, hydrogen cyanide. So HCN is a weak acid. Okay, so the answer adalah D. Okay, so combination dia. Macam tu lah, kena pecahkan dia dulu. Okay, so kita tengok yang the next question ni sama juga 70% je boleh jawab. So sama juga cara dia. Pecahkan dia, so that means K will become K plus and O2 and O2 minus. Okay, so K usually come from KOH lah. Okay, so KOH, kita tahu this is a base and dia adalah strong base. Okay, so yang mana strong base tu betul, yang weak base ni dah salah, ini salah. Okay, so kita kena identify antara A and C lah. So H, H pula. NO2 datang daripada, baru saya sebut tadi. NO2 minus might come from H.
NO3. 2.
HNO2. Okay. So NO2 minus come from HNO2. HNO2, we call it as, kita panggil apa?
Nitric acid.
Almost there.
Nitrate.
Yes. Okay. Nitrous acid. Okay, so ini keadaan, ini kamu kena ingat lah. Ini tricky sikit eh. Saya saja nak highlight on this one. This is two different acid tapi almost dekat-dekat nama dia. Sebab formula dia pun nak dekat-dekat juga. So HNO3, we call it as nitric acid. HNO2 is nitrous acid. And dia ada dua, dia ada perbezaan yang sangat besar. HNO3 adalah strong acid. HNO2 adalah weak acid. Okay, so please remember this one. Okay, so dia benda yang berbeza. So in this case, we can say that KNO2 is formed from the combination of strong base and weak acid. Okay, so strong base, weak acid. So that's why the answer is C. Okay, so itu cara kita identify salt tu lah. Okay, and then this one pun sama juga. MgSO4, kita separatekan dia, become Mg2 plus and SO4 to minus. Okay, so SO4 to minus usually come from apa?
H2SO4.
Sulfuric acid.
Yes, H2SO4, sulfuric acid. Okay, so sulfuric acid ini famous sangat. Kita tahu ini adalah strong acid. So, if this is strong acid, so yang mana jawapan strong acid betul, yang mana jawapan weak acid tu kita dah boleh pangkar dah. Okay, so Mg, so Mg might come from MgOH lah. Okay, so ini baru tadi kita discuss kalau strong base, dia metal group 1, group 2 combine with OH. So that's mean MgOH adalah strong base. Okay. So kalaulah saya tukar soalan ni, saya tanya MgSO4 apa type of salt dia? Adakah dia neutral, acidic or basic salt?
Neutral.
Neutral.
Yes. Okay, so you should be able to answer this, okay, confidently lah, sebab MgSO4 dua-dua adalah dari, datang daripada strong acid and strong base. So this is neutral salt, okay? So neutral salt lah. Okay, and then next one, last one, I think the last one. Yes. Okay, which type of salt of the following salt are classified as? Okay, the following salt. Okay, satu salt je pun. Okay, so K2SO4. Okay, nak di- identify salt tu jenis apa, kita kena tahu juga ion dia apa. So kita belah dia, so jadi K plus dengan SO4 to minus. Okay, so kita dah tahu ini datang daripada H2SO4, which is strong acid. Okay, so K usually come from K?
KOH.
Yep, thank you. Okay, so KOH, KOH pun kita dah tahu this is strong base. Okay, so now combination strong acid, strong base. KOH. That's why the answer adalah neutral salt. Okay, so ada apa-apa soalan about salt dissociation ataupun salt hydrolysis?
Tidak, miss.
Okay, alright. So kalau tak ada, saya rasa yang tu je lah yang saya nak discuss hari ni. Okay, so nanti kamu sambung buat kerja yang buffer tu. Buffer tu, you have to really understand apa function dia, kenapa keadaan dia macam tu. So that pengiraan tu kamu boleh faham. As you can see, there are three example yang saya bagi dekat situ sebab memang soalan tu keadaan dia berbeza. Okay, so keadaan berbeza tu menyebabkan pengiraan dia slightly different. So please pay attention dekat situ lah, tengok. Okay, kalau dia bagi volume macam mana, kalau dia tak bagi macam mana, so and so on. Okay, so kalau tak ada apa-apa dah, saya rasa saya stop kat sini. So kamu boleh sambung buat kerja kamu lah. Okay, so thank you semua.
Thank you, miss.
Thank you, miss.
Thank you, miss.
Thank you, miss. Thank you, miss.
Thank you, miss.
Thank you,
miss.
Thank you.
Have a nice
day. Okay, thank you. Bye.
Have a nice day.
Yes, you too, Alicia.
Miss.
Yes.
Ada ke value pH zero, miss?
pH zero, zero point something macam ada. Zero, exactly zero. Saya tak perasan lah pula. Uh-uh. Tak boleh nak menjawab. Kenapa? Concentration dia 1. Tapi mungkin macam possible juga. Macam possible sebab kalau ikut range macam macam boleh.
Strong acid lah kalau begitu.
Strong acid, yes.
Tapi so far kita akan jumpa dalam lab pH equal to 1 macam tu je lah.
Okay, jadi possible kan?
Nanti saya confirm kan balik. Tapi saya rasa possible.
Okay, miss. Thank you.
Okay. Bye-bye. Okay, korang. Bye. Stop recording.